This is Tyler from Second Swing Golf. We're here at Ping today with Marty Jertson from Ping, talking about what Ping really means, how it focuses on fitting, and one of the exciting, you know, new product families that's coming out with the G400. So Marty, I kind of want to start off with, let's talk about how important fitting is to Ping and, you know, what that really means. So tell us a little bit about kind of the fitting element as it pertains to Ping.
Yeah, it's always been an important part of our process. Obviously, I think Karsten brought a lot of the original tools to the marketplace and the industry that's helped everybody get fit better, make the whole process easier. And it's still at the heart of what we do in the design process is we want to make sure we're designing our standard specs for the marketplace optimally, but also have that wide range of fitting options and the right levers to pull. So all the way from shafts, Lingle, grip size, swing weight, total weight, loft offerings, kind of different left-right bias. We want to make sure we design all those fitting variables in to allow folks like yourself and our retailers out there to be able to pull different knobs and levers. And, you know, I think the ultimate from a golfer's perspective is to have the best design product combined with the best fitting. And when you merge those two things, great things happen.
So, and one of the really neat things that Ping is going to be rolling out here soon is the new color code chart. And as I understand it, that's kind of to help us as the fitter better educate the consumer to ensure that they're getting properly fit and understand what that fitting really means. Talk to us about what the changes are coming with the color code chart.
Yeah, we've really tried to simplify the process for folks like yourself of using our fitting tools, so our fitting cart and our fitting chart. So for a long time, what we did is we took care of, on the back end, the loft and length dependency. And so we're removing that from the process. So now, from if you have an AFS head or one of our advanced fitting cart heads, now you can take that head and that length, and if you have a certain length and a certain color code, now when you order your set from us, it's going to be, for example, 1 degree upright blue, plus a half inch. You will just order your set at a degree and a half up blue plus a half inch. You won't have to do any conversions on the back end. So we've really simplified things. We've gone back, we've removed a couple color codes that we added, yellow and purple. We've taken those back out. So kind of going back to our old kind of color code sweep and made it a lot easier for you and our customers to just simply understand. You know, you have your length fitting, you have your Lingle fitting, and you can order clubs exactly with our fitting tools now out there in the market.
Yeah, and it's such an important element, right? Because we want the consumer to know that they're getting fit for that right product, and simplifying that process will help both the fitter and the consumer understand that. You know, a big thing for Ping is they've had these very clearly defined product cycles, right? They've got the G line, they've got the I line, they've got the I blade. Talk to us about what goes into Ping kind of trying to encompass the entire market and how you kind of cater to each one of those product cycles.
Yeah, good question. So we really try to define for our I player, for example, our I200 iron, what are the characteristics of that player? And what are they looking for in performance? What is their preference from a size and shape standpoint? Then what do they need from a performance standpoint? Should their priority be more on distance or distance control? Should it be more on forgiveness or workability? How do we weigh and balance all those factors? Same thing for our G and now our G400 customer, right? It's what are the priorities for that player, that customer, and really get detailed and list those things out. That really helps us frame our R&D that we do and ultimately all the technology that goes into the different product.
Sure. And now one of the big things too is that's a big product line that's been launched here for a little while with a couple new models coming is the Sigma G. You've got a lot of different putters in that lineup to cater to a bunch of different stroke types, obviously, with the putters, but you've also got a lot of different head variations now, something that you've certainly expanded upon that. Talk to us about Sigma G a little bit, kind of what that putter's doing and why we've got all these different models now.
Yeah, the Sigma G is a fun line for us because we have the freedom as designers to kind of appeal to a broad spectrum of preferences. So like you said, preferences from a weight and stroke type standpoint, but just the wide array of models is pretty phenomenal. We have old traditional purist looking test model with a lot of toe flow, we'll call it, or a very toe down putter that feels amazing, all the way from very high inertia, counterbalanced dune, super stable, exotic. No one's ever seen a putter like that. So that was a lot of fun for us to have something that appeals to the broad spectrum from a model standpoint, number one. Mm-hmm. Then we've varied the head weights a lot within that. We have different finishes. We have some light, some dark. We have different stroke types. Now we're dropping in a couple new mallets. The Tine has been a great model for us. This
Definitely.
Really cool fork style archetype. Lines up easy. It's been very popular on tour. Picks the ball up easy when you have a gimme, because you're going to have a lot of gimmies with that putter.
Definitely.
And then the feel of the family is really fun. So it's kind of got this nice soft feel, but the ball still comes off as you expect off the face. So the face technology, obviously it speeds up your off-center hits to reduce three putts. It's still a technology that's a lot of fun to be able to pass on to players.
Absolutely. And you know, one of the big reasons why we're down here at Ping today is to kind of take a look at the exciting new lineup with the G400 that we touched on a little bit earlier. Marty, in our conversations earlier today, it sounds like there's been so much technology that's gone into the G400 line, a lot of research and development. Can you hone in on and touch on some of those things that you were looking for to improve upon the very successful G line to now what is G400?
Yeah, it's a good one. It was so much work in a lot of different areas. So what we wanted to do was to maintain kind of our lead in just the overall engineering horsepower, right? We, you know, our driver, the G driver, is the most forgiving. It's the most stable. It's super long, but also at the same time very straight. We wanted to expand that, but across the whole G400 family, just upgrade the overall emotional and impact experience you have with the club. We wanted to create product that was motivating and rewarding for you to hit. And so for us, what that meant is really working on the sound, the feel, the acoustics, the shaping. So to really combine kind of a lot of unique design characteristics with our engineering horsepower. So now for the driver, for example, it goes faster through the air, has some really amazing aerodynamic properties. It produces more ball speed from the forge face, but at the same time it has a deeper, more muted impact sound and feel that players absolutely love, and you get addicted to hitting it. So we've kind of approached things from the real technical side all the way to the experiential side.
So a couple of the things that I kind of took out of the conversations that we've had earlier today is MOI is at a number that has not been seen in the industry before. Mm. And G was already the leader there.
Yeah.
The other things is you're also increasing ball speeds, especially off of the driver, fairway, and hybrid, all mm-hmm. the above, including the irons.
Yep.
Talk to us a little bit about what you did specifically in the driver, let's start there, to increase those ball speeds for that customer.
Yeah, so how do we get driver ball speed? Primarily through two ways. And so we can think about it as we got more club head speed. And we did that by making the driver knife cut through the air easier. Mm-hmm. So we changed the shaping of the driver, made it a little more streamlined in its shaping, so that from the beginning of your downswing, down near impact zone, when the face is rotating in, it has less size or shape that the air pushes back on. So we're getting about 6/10 a mile an hour in ball speed from the improved aerodynamics. Then we're getting the other half, the other 6/10, from the forge face and the face being 6% thinner. Hmm. So we're getting more flexibility out of the face is thinner. We're improving ball speeds not only in the center, but also around the perimeter, regardless of your kind of impact stat area. So we're getting more speed from the aerodynamics and more speed from the face technology and the forge T9S Plus face.
Yeah, the driver is amazing. I was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to hit it earlier today, and I could definitely tell dispersions was tighter, but the biggest thing that I noticed was it definitely was generating faster ball speeds in comparison to my gamer. So you as a consumer out there are going to have that opportunity to stop in a second swing and get fit for that, which is going to be awesome. But in addition to the driver, the fairway and hybrid, there's a new,
Mirage steel.
Yeah. On the face of the fairway and the hybrid. Talk to us a little bit about that, what you were seeing. One of the big things that we talked about today was the flex of the face and how that was making such a big improvement. I think that's such a cool story. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so we're on a mission. Our fairways have been great. They get the ball in there easy. They launch easy. They're very versatile. Now, we were on a mission with the G400 Fairywood and Hybrid to get more ball speed, more pop off the face, bring more heat to the face. So we went searching for the strongest, most flexible steel we could find. So the material that we selected and found was called Miraging C300. And it's one of the strongest steels in the world, but it's also super flexible. So that's what we care about. We care about flexibility and strength. It's also very tough. It's a material like we talked about using landing gear for airplanes, mm-hmm. Because it can withstand a lot of those landings and flex during the impact. So the result is we designed the face thinner and get the face to flex in the fairway about 30% more. So now the face is flexing about the whole entire face thickness during the impact. And the result, 2 miles an hour more ball speed in both the fairway and the hybrid from this Miraging face.
And so that 2 miles an hour more ball speed is going to equate to more distance. And the other thing that we saw too is that from a launch perspective, it's the same, but your max height is quite a bit higher, so it's landing considerably softer for both of those club types.
Yeah, absolutely. So higher peak trajectory in fairway woods is generally a good thing, but we obviously, as we talked about, we have a lot of fitting options.
Exactly.
Stretch 3 gets up there in there very easy for the faster swing speed player. Then we also added the 9 wood and the 7 SFT as great fitting options on the opposite end of the bag.
You've got the entire gamut covered. Lastly, let's talk about the irons. I think it's such an interesting product. You've got that hydro pearl finish now on mm-hmm. there. Talk to us a little bit about, the big key takeaway for me is that this is a hot iron, but there are no hot spots. The entire face is hot. Talk to us about what that really means and what the consumer is going to see from that iron.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up because that was on the top of our priority list. We want to deliver an iron with more distance. If we can help somebody hit an 8-iron into the green instead of a 7-iron, they're going to hit it closer. They're going to have more forgiveness from just the more loft, the shorter club. That's really what the G400 iron does. It allows you to hit one less club into the bag, and they're going about 5 yards further, but also 5% higher. And the way that happens is how the face moves in response during the impact. So it's a Hyper 17-4 material that we age to get it real strong and flexible, just kind of like the properties similar that we're using in the fairway wood. And the face flexes like a catapult or diving board during the impact. So the face flexes in such a way that launches the ball higher without producing those hot spots or too over flexibility in the middle of the face. It's something that's very important to us from a design standpoint is to produce distance without sacrificing the peak trajectory and without introducing hot spots or distance control issues.
You know, the big takeaway that I come out of here with Ping today and having the opportunity to be here is fitting is and will continue to be an important core element to Ping, as it will be at Second Swing. You've got very defined product cycles that cater to the entire market, and there's an exciting new lineup with that G series and the G400 that we're excited to bring to our customers and have available for fitting. Thanks, Marty, for having us here at Ping today. We appreciate it very much.
Tyler.